Hi everybody, it's Stefanie from SexyPlus Clothing. I'm here with Sophia of Sophia Apostle Coaching. Yeah, I think we should be good now. You're live.
There it is.
So I know I haven't been here for, there's been a couple of Tuesdays. There was Valentine's Day, and of course I bailed. And then there was a day where we had some really bad weather. So I'm sorry that I've missed you for a couple of Tuesdays, but I'm back and I'm so excited to be here. So I'm here with Sophia. She's been on the show before and I'm so excited to have her back. She's a certified life coach, is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
With a specialty on coaching curvy women with regards to dating, right?
Yeah, dating, confidence, body confidence, all kinds of stuff, yeah.
So hi Simone and hi Jackie, thanks for joining. So Sophia's really kind of a one of a kind. Like there's a lot of varieties of life coaches out there. It's not a new term. There's been a lot of that, but with an emphasis and a care and a finesse with regards to how it is for curvy women is something I've never heard of before.
Yeah.
And you're kind of a trailblazer in that sense, right?
Yeah,
yeah, you are.
Yeah.
And we're lucky to have you.
Autograph.
Tracy Scott, hi, thanks for joining. Ladies, if there's any problems, we're trying to, talk as loud as we can and be visible here, and hopefully there's no static or other noises, but just put it in the comments if there are. Sophia shared your video. So that's a good point. Be sure to share this video and come back and put shared in the comments so that you can be entered to win the weekly prize. So getting back to Sophia. So today's show is kind of cool because we are going to do some live coaching with Sophia. And when she reached out to me and suggested the idea and asked me, what topic we could do, I thought, from my personal experience, networking, whether it's been in this business or in the job that I was in before, I was in a corporate job, I had to go to networking events. And, it's maybe some people flourish in that environment, and I bet there's a lot of other people who may have anxiety about networking events. How do I approach like a group of three strangers standing together, or how do I break the ice? How do I, make it seem like I'm there to support them, but really I'm like, here's my card,
yeah.
Right? And not make it seem like it's
like
all
you're a car salesman?
Yeah, exactly, right? Like we have this beautiful, red Volkswagen for you. So I thought that networking and maybe getting over some obstacles and maybe getting some techniques with regards to networking would probably be helpful to a lot of people. So before we jump into that, I wanted to ask, tell us a little bit more about what you offer and how you help women become their best selves every day.
Yeah. So I'm going to scream in poor Stephanie's ear and hope you guys can hear me well. So as a life coach, what I do is I partner with women, literally, like I always imagine us standing side by side, walking forward together. So unlike therapy, where if you go to a therapist, they're the expert, they're going to tell you, what's happened in your past and what to do differently. Coaching, I actually believe that the client has everything they need inside of them, but sometimes it's really hard to find. There can be layers or blocks or inner critic voices or judgments that actually stop us from living that best life.
Right.
So we do sometimes look back to see where some of the core wounding is from, where some of our past experiences have led us to where we are today. But most often we start with where you are right now, where you want to go, and then how to get there. And we do that by, there's different tools, different techniques. I love your topic for today, because what we're going to do is actually kind of use one of these techniques to tap into a version of your most confident self.
Okay.
So that when you go to a networking event, because really it's confidence, right? When we get nervous or if we see a grouping of two or three people, it's hard to break into that.
Yeah.
So if you're really in your confidence, then you can do that. But saying that and then actually doing it are two very different things.
Well, and it's interesting that you started off by saying, like, when you go to a therapist versus you, yeah. The way I kind of that the way that illustrated in my mind was you and therapist versus coach and you.
Exactly.
Right?
We're side by side.
Yeah, it's like therapist is sitting across the desk saying, you need to do this. And meanwhile, what you're providing is more like, here we go.
I always imagine us holding hands, swinging arms, like walking off into the sunset.
Like literally and figuratively.
Yeah.
Okay, sounds good. Hey, Kat. Katarina just joined. Let's jump right into it then.
Okay.
Let's do some coaching with regards to networking.
Yeah. And so we're gonna keep this really short. We may not get fully where we're gonna go, because just so you guys know, most coaching sessions are about an hour, and we're gonna do like 5 minutes.
Okay. So you're not gonna get it all.
No.
Okay.
But it's nice to give people a taste, because a lot of people don't know. Like, I get asked all the time. So, like, what is coaching? What do you do? How is it different than consulting or therapy? So we're gonna do a little demo.
Okay.
So the first thing I tell clients is that everything we say is fully confidential.
Right.
Which is not gonna be
not
the case
today.
So no one listen. No, I'm just kidding. So what we're gonna do is, you've already mentioned that it's this feeling that you have when you go into a networking space. So I want you to describe that feeling. So imagine, like, walking into that space, and let's say you really want to go and talk to a group of people because maybe there's an influencer or someone who you really want to know that's standing in a group of two or three people and they're all talking to each other.
How do you, like, break in there without being, awkward?
Right.
Yeah.
So instead of going right to the how do I, let's actually get in touch with how you feel as you're standing there looking at that group of people in that moment. What do you notice, like, happens in your mind, in your body, as you're looking?
I guess because the way that I think is very linear.
Yeah.
So if I was in that situation, I would be thinking, do I wait for a break in the conversation or for one of the people to walk away? I wouldn't just approach and stand there and shoulder elbow my way in. I would feel way too uncomfortable to do that. So I'd probably wait for like a break in something. I'd already have planned what I was going to say, and it would probably be a compliment or something like that to them. And then, introduce myself. But the idea of the whole thing, how I'm feeling, that would be my strategy.
Yeah. I was going to say, you're so strategic. You're like on it.
Yeah. But my feeling about the whole thing would be like, ugh.
Yeah.
I just want to go get one of those little cheese things and leave.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So the, what is that? Like, what does that represent?
What it is to me is that, like, I love connecting with people on a one-on-one, but not when it's a group.
Yeah.
So what it is to me is, like, bleh, small talk.
Yeah.
Bleh. You know what I mean? Like, they don't know me. They don't give a shit about me.
Yeah.
Who am I? And also my motives for wanting to connect with them are probably business related.
Yeah.
Because if they were personal, I would not be there at all.
Right.
Right. I'd be hanging out with somebody one-on-one.
Yeah.
And I've noticed, like, growing up too, if I made plans, hi Patricia, hi Ophelia, thanks for joining. Sorry, we're totally ignoring you guys over there.
We're in the coaching.
but I noticed that growing up too, if I made plans with one girlfriend and she was like, oh, hey, so-and-so is going to join us, I would back out.
Yeah.
So I like
really like this.
One-on-one.
So that bleh feeling, what I hear there is there's some anxiety, some nervousness, some discomfort, like this is not my scene, but I have a higher purpose because for my business I want to do it. Yeah. And so you go right to strategy, which is great. It's okay. And I can almost picture you're like perched. You're like watching for the break and you're like, I'm going in, I'm saying my thing and I'm getting out. Is that kind of how it feels?
Yeah.
So what is the way, again, you feel that, I don't know if you guys get the sense, like when you're like, you kind of went like
you
this.
You feel it. Like my whole body language.
Yeah. It totally shifts. Yeah.
Yeah.
So how do you actually want to feel when you go into a station? What would the ideal,
like a butterfly going from flower to flower. Chit-chat comfortably and confidently and so smoothly with these people, and then flutter over here and do it with these people, and then flutter over there, and you know what I mean?
Like a social butterfly?
I was at an event the other night for my mom. She was competing for karaoke, and a whole bunch of her friends were there. So I had to like say hi to them, go through all the motions. So then I took her at the end of the night and I said, Mommy, when I'm leaving, I'm just going to leave, okay? I don't want to say bye to anybody. I just want to escape.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And I don't know if that's so much, I don't know if it's a confidence thing, because otherwise I'm a pretty confident person. I have high self-esteem. I just don't like it. It just makes me uncomfortable.
Yeah.
It feels like putting the wrong shoe on the wrong foot.
Yeah. Like an ill fit.
It
doesn't fit quite right.
Yeah.
And what you want instead is to, and you know, when you say butterfly flitting around, there's such a lightness and an openness, and you've got a little smile.
Right.
Like your whole demeanor from to social butterfly flitting around.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what do you notice feels different in your body? Even
I guess body language?
It? Yeah, like what emotions do you feel when you think about be the social butterfly?
I guess free and natural.
Yeah, exactly. What things do you do in your life where you do feel that feeling, free and natural?
Masturbating.
Now we're talking.
Hi, Godivar. Hi, Carrie. Thanks for joining. You guys joined in at the right time. free and natural. What else? I don't know. Dancing, I guess.
Dancing.
I can dance.
Yeah.
On the dance floor alone when nobody else is up there. You know those group of people that have to wait till there's two or three people already?
You're like, no problem. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So that would be a good example.
And there's so much confidence when you say that. There's so much like independence and like, here I am and
pride.
Owning it. Pride.
Yeah.
Ooh, good word.
Yeah.
So if you were to walk into a networking space in that dance energy, in that butterfly energy, with that, like, you know, what would...
Wonka, wonka. Hey, everybody, my Instagram. I'm going over here to this group.
That's right. I love
it. Getting lots of thumbs up there. But yeah, what a great way to change your outlook on it.
Yeah. So... we're going to wrap up really artificially quickly here.
I'm a dancing butterfly.
You are. You're a dancing butterfly. Exactly. So what we've just done is we've actually created a neural pathway, a new neural pathway in your mind that is connecting the feeling that you want to have
with
to the metaphor. Of the dancing butterfly.
Right.
So now what
not
we
the masturbating
do,
butterfly.
Well, you could be a masturbating butterfly too. I actually really like that for you. I like that a lot. Because it brings out your playful side. Yeah, so good.
Berkeley, hi, long time. Thanks for joining. Lucia.
Oh, hi.
Nice
Lucia.
To see you.
It's my friend from California.
Awesome.
So now that we have that image, now what we need, we always need reminders. So it's not just enough to be like, okay, I'm going to remember the next time I go to a networking event in a month, I'm going to show up as the dancing masturbating butterfly. You want to create a visual reminder and have it on your person. I actually really love to do it with jewelry.
Okay.
You do it with Post-its. I use the
or like a pineapple.
Phone. Yeah.
Like Sarah had, she modeled the pineapple dress. And she said, she said, be a pineapple.
Yeah.
You know, stand tall, wear a crown,
and
be sweet on the inside.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So you could have like a little pineapple choker or something like that.
So it would be whatever your version is that reminds you
it
of
could even
that
be a
energy.
Rock in your pocket that is your dancing
butterfly.
A lot
butterfly. Of women put rocks in their bras actually.
Right.
Which is interesting to keep it close to your heart.
Yeah.
I suggest having two or three. So here's what I would suggest for you, the next networking event. You're going to drive to your networking event. I want a Post-it note in your car where you can see it like on the dash or somewhere with like a picture of a butterfly.
Yeah.
Or a vibrator. It's your choice. And then have something like visual on you, like whether it's a rock in your pocket or some kind of necklace or pendant that
or
reminds
hair flower
you, yeah,
or something
that remind you of that energy. And also, I'm a big fan of using my phone lock. I'm going to show you guys. This is something. Oh, hang on. Do it again.
I do that with my passwords.
I do this right now. You know, this is a card that I pulled that's all about restore and replenish, which is what energy I've been wanting to
bring.
So you want to set up reminders for yourself. So you take that into your next event.
Yeah.
And then really like purposely, intentionally, consciously get into that energy as you walk in. for you, I would say you're going to want to sashay into that door. You know, dance a little bit where no one can see you.
Yeah.
Go in the bathroom if you want. Do a little thing. There's actually a really important, there's a really great TED Talk that talks about if you want to, like, get confidence. This is before a job interview, before a public speaking event, before a networking event. You go up like this with your arms, like this, and then you go Superman pose, and it changes something in your brain.
Oh, I love it.
Amy Coulter, I think is her name on the TED Talk. So do your version of that with your dancing, with your butterfly, and allow that confidence to be there, and that all that feeling, that lightness, that fun, and then go in, and it'll shift it.
Great, great technique. I love it. Thank you.
Yeah. And then, of course, there's always accountability. So whenever we're going to talk about what your next when your next event is, and then I'll have
I'll have to report back.
Yeah.
Okay.
Always have to report back.
Well, I hope that you guys caught that and how, you know, effective, I guess, in a much more intensive, you know, hour-long version.
I would have you stand up and dancing and being
and there was a lot more work. Exactly. But the what a great concept. So, yeah, thanks for sharing that with us. That's great. Okay. So now it's time to try stuff on. You want to go first?
Yeah, I will.
Yeah, okay. So Sophia's going to go try on her favorite item. Carrie, you're missing your hair flower today. Actually, Carrie, I haven't been wearing them for a long time, maybe 2 years now. I don't know what happened to me. I still love them, but I don't know. They just don't feel authentic anymore, and you just have to be true to yourself, right? Like, I would go to style my hair, and I'd put it in, and I just felt like it didn't feel like me anymore. So I think the hair flowers phase for me may have passed. So here's Sophia. So she's wearing the Linden Lace top. It is
I'm gonna make it a little sexy for you guys.
Yeah, she's gonna pull down her cami there. This is one of the best-selling tops that I have here. It's by one of our favorite and Sophia's favorite brands called Kiona. It is lined, so it's got this beautiful, it's lined down there. It's a peplum and empire, right? So it's kind of like the waistline is right beneath the boobs, and then it's got this peplum, and then it's got this nice scalloped neckline.
Would you like to see?
The décolletage. and then the sleeves, as you can see, don't have the lining. But this is a great top for somebody who may want to wear something formal, but not a dress. If you're not a dress person, you could wear this with a beautiful pant.
Yeah.
Like, imagine it with, like, a coral pant even. Mm. Like a heavy, weighted coral pant and then a black shoe or something like that for a wedding. So, yeah, that's lovely. Thanks, Sophia. Beautiful. So that's the Linden Lace top. I think Simone says one of my faves. I think you're referring to the brand Kiona, right? so that's lovely. That's called the Linden Lace top. And I think I have a 2X and a 4X at the moment. Also, I have some really good news while we wait for Sophia to come back. I wanted to share with everybody that today I got approval to, welcome back, Sophia. I got approval from a brand called Rebdolls to be one of their retail stores carrying their line. So Rebdolls is very street, trendy, urban. They describe themselves as dope clothes on their website, okay? So here's an example, very similar to the existing SexyPlus brand, right? So this is just a simple black dress with a cage there. Here's another example. I absolutely love this one. I know it's hard to pull off white, but just with that hook and eye closure detail there, I love this one. Thank you, Simone. She's saying congrats. And then also really feminine things like this. Do you see that caged bust on there? The caged bust thing is just so beyond sexy.
It is so
I hope it
hot.
Never goes out of style.
I know.
It's so hot, yeah. So things like this, and they're affordable. So yay, Rebdolls will be, I think I'll be one of the first Canadian stores to carry Rebdolls. So I'm really excited about that.
Yeah.
And obviously Berkeley is as well. So I'm going to try on a lovely little lace top from the Point Zero brand. And I'll leave you in Sophia's hands until I get back.
All mine. So what I wanted to chat with you guys about really quickly is I am doing a little contest, and as a thank you for watching. So on my website, which is this, sophiaapostle.com/sexyplus, and I realized it might be backwards for you. So it'll be in all of the social that we do for after we post this video. And I'm going to do a little contest to give away 1 hour of free coaching with me. So if you're interested, you can go to my website, sophiaapostle.com/sexyplus, and you enter your name and email, and you'll be entered into the draw, which I'm going to do in 24 hours. This is like a short contest for Stefanie's and SexyPlus's loyal watchers. So, yeah, so you can go and do that. And what I'll do is I'll be emailing you who the winner is. I'll email that person probably right around this time tomorrow night. What else shall we talk about? Oh, she's coming back.
So
there she is.
Isn't this lovely?
Yeah, let's see here. Oh yeah.
So this is a lovely little
ooh, I like
crochet overlay top from Point Zero. And I just got it in, but I've only got a few left, so it is lined. Oh, okay. Hang on.
Yeah.
I pull that down there.
I love.
Yeah, so I've only got a few left, folks, so, and it's not on the website, it's only in store because I have too few to put online. But yeah, so it's lined here. What a lovely, like,
yeah,
spring piece, oh, right?
This is like, let's go for a picnic right now.
Yeah, like I feel really, really feminine.
Yeah.
And then it's got...
It's soft.
Yeah,
too.
It's very soft and,
yeah,
really pretty, guys. And can you see the price on that in there?
Oh, actually, is it here?
Yeah. This is...
$59.
Yeah, so $59, really good quality. The back, I think, is just plain, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so...
Yeah.
Yeah, do you guys like it? Let me come up close and show you that lace detail there.
Woo! You just want to show you a bosom.
So I'm going to go change.
Beautiful.
I'm going to go change and I'll leave you back to Sophia. Be right back, everybody.
Awesome. All right. Does anyone have any questions about coaching? Anything you want answered? Anything you want to ask me? I'm going to very likely write a column for one of the plus size magazines. I won't say which one yet because it hasn't been all confirmed. But where I have this idea for like an ask me anything, because the more I talk with women who are my clients, who are my friends, who are in this community, I realize that there are so many things that we just don't talk a lot about, kind of like these taboo topics. And I know for certain that if we don't talk about something, it's often because we've got some shame around it. And when we talk about it, when we bring light to that shame, when we expose it, the shame starts to go away. So, so I kind of want to do like a taboo topics with Sophia, ask me anything kind of column. So just putting that out there, if you have any questions like that, anything that you feel like you would want to ask anonymously, you can message me, you can PM me. Again, even if you message me, I would never share where it comes from, total confidentiality. But yeah, keep that in the back of your mind as something that is to come.
I am back. Hi, everybody. I hope you enjoyed our live little fashion show demonstrations there. I love that top. Actually, it's the first time, like, I haven't, sometimes I don't get the chance to try everything on, like, as it comes in, right?
It's cute.
And that one, I liked it, too, because it was, like, long enough to cover, you know,
belly.
The belly,
mm-hmm.
which a lot of us, you know, look for, and especially if you wear leggings, you want a little bit of that length. So I wanted to also remind you guys about, I still have a lot of stuff on winter clearance sale, and that's, like, 25 to 75% off. The prices have already been reduced, so you could just go, hello, Sophia, thanks for joining. So you could just go on the website and click on shop, and in the drop-down menu, go to sale, and maybe grab something there for, like, really, some of the prices are, like, ridiculous.
Awesome.
I sold a $19 dress the other day.
What?
No. all right, so... If it's your first time joining, remember to please share this video on your personal timeline, and then you need to come back and comment that you've shared it, and then that way we can capture that as an entry into our weekly prize draw. This week's prize is a $20 gift card for SexyPlus Clothing, and I'm going to ask Sophia to pick
so
the winner.
Names.
Teresa, hi, darling. Thanks for joining. Sorry I've been MIA the last couple of Tuesdays.
Yeah.
Thank you for sharing. So we are announcing this week's winner. Cynthia, hi. Thank you for sharing.
Jennifer Maybe.
So it'll be reversed there. Sorry. There you go. Congratulations. So you can use that $20 gift card online or in store, whatever you prefer. I will try to find you. And sometimes if people don't have a Facebook profile or if it's private, then I can't find them. So if you can send a message to the Sexy Plus Clothing page, if you're the winner, if you're Jennifer, if you've seen this, then reach out to me just in case I have trouble finding you. So congratulations. Thanks everybody for sharing. So Sophia, you have a trailblazer Tuesday that you wanted to mention tonight, right?
Yes. So my trailblazer is Lindy West.
Lindy West, yay!
Who is a spectacular woman who wrote this book. Well, she's done lots of stuff, but this is the book where I first found out about her, first learned about her. It's called Shrill. And it's the subtitle I love. It's Notes from a Loud Woman.
Okay, and, yeah, I like that.
Yeah, I know, right? And so Lindy's in Seattle. She's an editor, a writer, a performer, and I love this. Her work focuses on pop culture, social justice, humor, and body image. I think her book came out about a year and a half ago, and I read it, and it helped me greatly be able to say, I am a fat woman. And say that word, fat, claim it back, and just own it. So she really did that. She writes for The Guardian. She writes for GQ. She's done This American Life podcast a couple times. And I, for those of you who don't know, I actually am, I don't know that I can ever not be, a librarian of all things. So I worked as a librarian for 12 years before I became a coach. And I was at one of our big library conferences here in Canada a couple weeks ago, and Lindy West was the keynote speaker.
Oh, wow.
And I was invited to have lunch with her with a group of people.
Oh, my goodness.
It was amazing. And, you know, as you can tell, I'm pretty extroverted. I'm very comfortable talking. I met her. I'm like, hi.
Yeah, you were speechless.
I couldn't. I lost all ability to speak. But she was very gracious, and I got a picture with her.
That's
which
so
is
amazing.
Like, and she signed my book. I totally fangirled out. She's spectacular. So go find her podcast on This American Life. It was like the whole fat acceptance, body positive podcast. The book just came out in paperback, and it is spectacular.
And is she Canadian or is she in the
States?
She's
American. She's in Seattle.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And do you know her Instagram?
Yeah, I think it's the
Lindy West.
Yeah.
Or the Lindy West.
Type in Lindy West and you'll find it.
Right,
she was
okay.
active on Twitter, huge, but because of the Trump craziness and all the trolling that she's gotten, she's actually made a choice, and she talked about this in her keynote, a really conscious choice to get off Twitter until Twitter does a better job of protecting, thank you.
Even not in
people
her presence, she still has that effect
even,
on
I know,
you.
I can't even talk. I love you, Lindy. because she was getting trolled, she's had death threats, like crazy stuff. Oh, she also is really controversial, and I think fabulous for this, but she has she co-founded the hashtag Shout Your Abortion. So she's very loud and proud and out there. And
it's not easy to be that person too, because for instance, even in my, you know, world of, you know, Sexy Plus, I have 25,000 fans on Facebook, 50,000 some on Instagram, which I've built over the years. Even sometimes when I have an opinion on something, I still feel like, I can't do that because I'm going to offend this person and that person and da-da. So sometimes to be able to stand up for, you know, a cause or an opinion or, you know, a principle, you risk alienating a lot of people who
Absolutely.
May not agree with you. Mm-hmm. And so it takes a lot of courage to do it loud, to do it proud, to write a book about it, you know what I mean? To overcome that and just, it's kind of like, you know, a success story in being your authentic self, right?
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, and she really owns every part of it. In a beautiful and in a graceful way, you know, like she's very
not obnoxious,
she's
loud,
not
but
obnoxious.
Just
But you know, a loud woman is still considered a loud woman, which is why she called this book Shrill.
Right.
Because it's such a female term. It's like a witchy, shrill woman. She's like, you know what?
Yeah.
If that's what you want to call me because I have an opinion, fine, bring it.
And it rhymes with frill it. And watch me twirl. So there, right? Cool.
Yeah.
All right, so I think that kind of brings us to the end of our show. Little short one today, folks. So upcoming guests, I don't have any upcoming guests.
I'll come back.
You're welcome anytime.
Every week.
So if you just want to come hang out, you're a customer, you're not a customer, you just want to come and hang out with me, that's fine. Or because the Facebook Live videos have a substantial reach, we get about 2,000 views per video and about 6,000 reach, which is, people's friends who see the video coming up in their feed and stuff like that. So, so, 6,000 people just from, us kind of hanging out and having fun and trying stuff on is pretty cool. So if you have a small business that you think would connect with the SexyPlus clothing audience, which is not just curvy women, but we have students, we have models, we have business women, So we have moms, So a lot of different women. So if you have a small business and you think that it could serve the SexyPlus fan base, then come and be my guest. I'll help promote you because it's, women supporting women, right?
Absolutely.
Any other comments, anybody? Let me flip back here to a couple of these comments and see if we missed anything. Donna Castor, hello. Heather Monroe, thanks for sharing and joining. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. I hope you enjoy, if you're living in Ontario, the wonderful warm weather, even though it means...
Well, tomorrow.
Even though it's because of global warming.
Yeah, well...
Right. Another sad face. It's. I'm kind of like, oh.
I know.
Yeah, I'm very sad about it. Thumbs up, Katarina. I will call you on my way home. I always call her on my way home.
Oh, do you?
And we're like, was I good? Did you like that?
Aww.
Was it entertaining? Which part was your favorite?
And what did
you
say?
We're so girly. Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, so reach out to me if you want to be a guest on an upcoming show. Sophia, thank you for being here again.
Yeah.
Are you shopping later? Because every time you say you're not going to buy something and then you buy
something. Stop tempting me.
Stop it. Right?
Stop it.
So have a great week, everybody. Thanks so much. Love you. Bye.
Bye.